subscribe to Nykaa TV and press the bell icon to make sure you never miss an update from us.
Makeup is an art, and as a makeup expert, it's very important for you guys to know all the techniques that the makeup industry has to offer. I'm Deepal Haria, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to use the airbrush technique, which is absolutely amazing because it gives a very flawless finish on the skin. Understand what airbrush makeup is all about. Airbrush makeup is a technique where you spray makeup onto the face rather than using different techniques like the brushes and the sponges and the different methods. The reason why airbrush is so popular is because of the high definition television and videos which have all come out. I personally love airbrush makeup because it's so flawless and gives a very sheer finish, which I would love for all my brides and my models for shoots. And I feel like it's perfect for your special occasion as well. And that's my beautiful model Maya, and I'm gonna be demonstrating my airbrush look on Maya today.
I've seen so much of this technique on Instagram and all over the net, and I'm really excited to see how it's going to look on me.
Trust me, you're gonna love it. The first step is using a primer, which is by Wet n Wild. It's called Cover All. Preferably use a primer which is silicone based and at the same time it's matte. Apply it all over the face, especially on the T-zone. So this is the Temtu Air Gun, and I love this product because it has a compressor as well as the gun in the same machine. This is the compressor, and this is where the air flows from. In order to start the product, you need to press and hold the product, is when the product has started. There are three levels on the compressor. When you press it once, you get the lowest level. You can use the lowest level for doing very defined work. You can press the two or the three, which is giving out more air, for bigger things like foundation and blush on, whatever is convenient for you. You'll be seeing how I switch between the levels of the compressor in order to control the flow of my gun. So I'm starting by using the Temtu foundation, and the name is Sand. Make sure before using the product, you are mixing the foundation well. I'm going to add a few drops in my airbrush gun. Pressing and holding the gun and starting it. Make sure that before applying the foundation, you are maintaining a minimum of 4-finger distance from the gun to her face. Starting the compressor, I'm keeping it on level 2. Pull the lever slowly and start the application in circular motions. Now I'm turning on the compressor to 3 to add a little more intensity on a foundation. Also make sure while you're doing the foundation, you take some on the neck as well. To avoid any patches on the skin, make sure you're constantly moving and you don't wait at any particular spot, otherwise it will look really bad. As the product comes out of the spray form, you'll hardly be able to see the product coming on your face, but you'll see magic on the skin. In order to dry out the foundation on the skin, I'm going to release the lever, leave the compressor on, and just going to brush it over her face. And this will help set the foundation as there's all the air coming out of the gun. Remember that airbrush makeup is not for the people who like heavy makeup. It gives a very sheer finish. So everyone who likes to go very subtle with their makeup, they can totally opt for this. Also, please note that anyone who has a lot of pigmentation and discoloration on the skin can avoid the airbrush makeup. Before moving on to the next product, I'm going to quickly clean the pores with the cleanser. Make sure you put 2 drops in the pores. Start your compressor, and you can take any dry tissue and just remove the excess from this. After the foundation, I'm moving on to the contouring, and I'm using the shade named Cappuccino, and it's perfect for her skin. For the contouring, you can use the basic technique where she just needs to pout a little. I'm setting my compressor on 2, and you can take this line as your contouring area. Make sure you don't pull the lever too much, just as much as required. Also, don't forget to maintain some distance from her face. If you press the lever too much, there are chances that there might be a patch on the contouring area. So keep it extremely light. You can use some on the corner of a forehead as well. After the contouring, I'm moving on to the blusher. I'm using the Temptu's Blush On shade. Just very minimum product. My compressor is on the level 2. She just needs to smile a little and you can get the area for the blush on. And make sure that you are blending the blush on with the contouring so you don't leave any patches. After the blush on, I'm releasing the lever and just airing her face so that the blush on sets. Now moving on to the last step of the airbrush, which is the highlighting. I'm using the Ivory shade by Temptu. Keeping the compressor on too, to do my highlighter, I'm gonna take the C on her face and apply it right over there. You can take it a little on the nose as well as the lips. Wow, I'm loving how this look has turned out, because that's the reason why I like airbrush, because it gives a very dewy finish. I'm gonna quickly finish off my makeup by using Huda Beauty's Power Bullet. The name is Rendezvous. You can ask your model to smile so that you can fill in the gaps wherever required. I love how this has turned out and I'm sure you're gonna love this. You wanna check it out?
Oh wow, I love how it doesn't feel heavy on my skin at all and it's really lightweight, but it still gives really good coverage.
Yeah, it does.
It's pretty much perfect.
After the airbrush makeup, you do not need a setting spray to set your base because it all sets by itself. If you have any questions, do mention that in the comments below and don't forget to like and share this video if you liked it and subscribe to Nykaa TV for much more. Thank you so much.